If not now, tell me when. If not now, tell me. To mend, it will take a change of heart for this to mend. But miracles do happen, every shining now and then. If not now, if not now, tell me when.
This is really a terrific and unique community event. It brings together all the best of Bloomington, I think. We have wonderful artists in this community who donate the bowls that are available for people tonight. We have a wide variety of terrific restaurants in this community with all sorts of food, and they donate the soup. It's a very volunteer-oriented community, and we use dozens and dozens of volunteers to pull this event together, and it all comes together for a very good cause, to fight hunger. That's what we do at the Hoosier Hills Food Bank, and this benefit supports our efforts to do that for six counties in South Central Indiana. So it's really just a marvelous community gathering. The main drivers in starting it were Carrie Newcomber and Robert Midas, who have remained with the Volunteer Soup Bowl Committee for all 16 years. They just had the great idea to get this going and did 16 years ago.
We didn't come up with the idea. We were in Wisconsin, Menominee, outdoor venue, and the guy, Mike Kettu, I think it's K-E-T-T-U for the record, was hosting and presenting the concert, and he told us about this event they held where they just got a small group together, maybe 50 people, I'm guessing, if I remember correctly, and they made bowls. They jointly made bowls and brought soup, made homemade soup, and they raised hundreds or maybe a few thousand dollars for a local fundraiser. And so Carrie and I came home to Bloomington, and we had just moved down here maybe two or three years before, and we said, that's a great idea, let's do our own version of it.
I just remember that 16 years ago we had this great idea, and I think maybe we made about $4,000 that first year, and it was at the Catholic Church, as I recall.
And it was a small event, but every year it almost doubled or more every year. Word really spread, and it had an amazing life of its own after a while. So it's been really rewarding to see it grow.
I just think it's so amazing the way it's evolved from the basement of the Catholic Center at IU to Harmony School to St. Mark's to the Convention Center, and we just can't get any bigger. We're limited by our artists and by the bowls that they can make, and without them, it just wouldn't be the same event.
What has remained constant is the ingredients of the event, and the potters are at the beginning giving us all these bowls, most of them for free, some of them we do wholesale. And Barb Lund has been a great provider of many, many bowls over the years and has saved us when we ran short.
And I remember that first time we all made bowls and brought them in, and then I brought bowls and I went home, and I remember Suzanne calling me two or three times, the last phone call being, Barb, bring every bowl you have. Because there were all these people lined up out there, and so many more people showed up than anybody ever expected.
I had moved here from Colorado, and people knew I was a potter, so they asked me to donate pots. So I started out donating, and then it looked like it really needed some organization, and so I'm good at that, and that's when I started taking it on, about 2 years into it. It might have been the second year or the third year, something like that.
And then when Karen came to the community, she just moved in to take over the potter's role, and we're really thankful.
What goes into it is pretty phenomenal. This is a bowl, actually, that was fired in my kiln. I didn't make it. This was made by Milton Nolan. But he came over, he didn't have a kiln to fire it in, so he fired it in using my glazes, and then I fired it in my kiln. And when you think about a bowl like this, first of all, the materials, the clay, this could be millions of years old. Milton got it in his hands, you know, in the form of clay ready to use. And so it's been through, you know, from a million years ago to today, it's gone through a lot of steps. And one of it is that it's through his hands. It's through his inspiration and his desire to take something out of the earth and make it really beautiful and functional. And I think this is just, you know, an exquisite piece.
I have to say, it's the potters and the fact that you get the bowl that makes this event come together and be unique. I really think that's it. I think everything else is wonderful and we're so appreciative. I think that the uniqueness of the event is that you leave with your bowl, which you'll use for years.
I think it's just so symbolic of what we are as a community because it combines all the best of Bloomington, the arts, the food, the interest in hunger issues and in our social consciousness of taking care of the people who live in our community. It's just such a great gathering and a coming together from different perspectives and different communities. It's an inspiring, feel-good event.
We share our resources, we share the knowledge that we have, and we share our energy, and we come out with this incredible event that's, you know, two hours at most, and we make a lot of money for the food bank that then goes out to people who need it, who are down on their luck.
It makes the community far more aware of the food bank and of what the food bank does, and it's absolutely vital to the whole region's existence. And when I talk to other people out in the community, it's absolutely one of their favorite things in the entire year, the great social events that happens here. You've given money, but you're getting something back that you get that's tangible, that you get to hold as well.
It's really been amazing being in this from the beginning and see how it's grown. It's a very rewarding thing to do, and I do all the posters and the programs and all the graphics work for it.
I'm organizing the soup crew. So we serve the soup, we get it from the kitchen into the heating pans, we make sure the soup is there and that people know what it is, and we try and organize things as best we can. It seems to be the most chaotic part of the event, but we get through it. Probably about 6 years ago, we found Phil, who works at Blooming Foods in his day job, and has taken over in the kitchen. And Phil is the master, and couldn't do it without him.
Last year, we raised about $80,000 from this benefit, and this year we probably won't make quite that much because we lost a couple of our corporate sponsors due to the economy. But we'll definitely raise well over $70,000, and that's just it's just huge to support our efforts at the food bank. This is the largest single fundraiser that we have all year, and it's very important to our ability to keep doing what we're doing.
This is one of those community efforts that makes Bloomington what's Bloomington, and we self-organize, and this is a group that puts us together. We have one meeting a year. We all know what we're supposed to do, and we do it.
And it sort of happens automatically now. I hate to say it, but we've all just gotten so used to doing it, the press so used to supporting it, and the people so used to buying tickets that it does sell out. We don't want to be overly confident, but we are confident in the community in supporting this event.
That it's limited and that it sells out every year, it makes it kind of a high-end event, even though it's certainly not high cost.
In dollars and cents, it's meant food on people's tables, and that's the bottom line. It's very heartwarming to see not only individuals donating bowls, but businesses donating money to make this happen. And the soup is a huge gift. And everyone that donates anything is a part of making this a better community and making this a community where our people can be fed and cared for and comforted. Mm-hmm.